Good morning, class. Yesterday we were discussing about the picornaviruses, the family picornaviridae, and particularly about the FMD virus and FMD, that's foot and mouth disease. Let's just recapitulate first the important points of related to FMD virus, and then we'll continue this further. Then we have seen that picornaviridae, maybe members of the family picornaviridae, they are very small in size, because in Spanish the pico means very small. You have seen in measurements also, we go for nanogram, picogram. So pico means very small. So picornaviruses, they are very small in size. They come under group 4 Baltimore classification system. These are positive sense single stranded RNA viruses. Virions, they are almost 30 nanometers in diameter. Icosahedral symmetry is there. They are non-enveloped and they contain single stranded RNA. There are certain important structural proteins present in the capsid of picornaviruses. These are VP1, VP2, VP3 and VP4. Out of all these, VP4 is located inside or on the inner surface of the capsid. Rest all are present in the outer surface of the capsid. Then viral replication, because this virus is a RNA virus, its replication occurs in the cytoplasm. Then the family comprises of certain important genera, out of which aptosvirus, enterovirus, cardioviruses and hepatoviruses, they contain the viruses of veterinary significance. So all these viruses, they come under picornaviridae family, and these are the virus present in these genus. And we have discussed in detail about the foot and mouth disease virus. So foot and mouth disease is caused by your aptoviruses, and they are unstable at pH below 6.5. FMD is highly contagious disease of even-toed ungulates, and main characteristic feature is your fever and formation of vesicles on all the epithelial surfaces. Then this FMD is a list A disease of major economic importance internationally as well. So there were 7 isolates or serotypes or subtypes, serotypes of FMD virus, which were OAC, Asia 1, SAT 1, SAT 2 and SAT 3. Out of all these, mostly prevalent are O, A and C. इसमें से भी हमारे इंडिया में सबसे ज़्यादा प्रेवलेंट इज योर ओ सब टाइप, सीरोटाइप ओ. तो द वायरस इज ऑल्सो जूनोटिक इन नेचर, इट कैन अफेक्ट ह्यूमन बींग्स, बट द इन्फेक्शन इज अनकॉमन. सो FMD इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड एज अ पब्लिक हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम. देन वी हैव सीन द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ FMD. इट्स बाल्टीमोर ग्रुप 4, ऑर्डर इज नाइडोविरल्स, फैमिली इज पिकोर्नाविरिडी, जीनस वी आर स्टडिंग हियर इज एप्थोवायरस, species is your foot and mouth disease virus, and type species which is most commonly prevalent is your strain O. Then replication we have discussed, replication occurs in the cytoplasm, and replication itna rapid hai that its cycle gets completed between 5 to 10 hours mein. So it's very highly replicative and very rapidly multiplying virus. Genome sense, the genome is positive sense genome, it immediately acts as your template strand, or it directly acts as mRNA which gets translated into certain proteins. So this in short was the replication strategy of picornaviruses or aptoviruses. These are the sequence of events, but the gist of all this sequence of events is that the virus is so rapid in replication that the whole of the replication cycle, it gets completed within 6 to 10 hours. Then we can cultivate the virus on cell cultures and also in lab animals. Then jitne bhi cloven footed animals, and they all are affected by this FMD. It's distributed almost all throughout the world. The FMD is distributed. Transmission could be various ways, or various means of transmission are there, like for direct or indirect contact, through aerosols, through garbage, through artificial insemination, through inanimate objects. So all these are the means of transmission of the viruses. Then another important point we have discussed is that sheep is a maintenance host for FMD virus, pig acts as amplifier, and cattle acts as indicator host. Do remember this, these are very important points to remember in if we talk about FMD. FMD वैसे भी important है आपके long answer question के लिए. So exam में आपके लिए अगर long में कोई disease आ सकती है तो FMD could be one of that. So do remember the details of FMD. You need to write the symptoms, signs and symptoms, lesions, replication strategy, you need to mention the host, different host. You need to mention the classification system of the FMD virus. So this is all the important points are: sheep attacks as a maintenance host, pigs are the amplifiers, and cattle acts as indicator host. So FMD virus incubation period kam hai iska 24 to 48 hours. Morbidity though it's high 100% hai. Mortality is usually less than 1%. Symptoms ki baat karein to mostly symptoms are in cattle. High fever is there, the fall in milk production, excessive salivation, drooling, nasal discharges, lameness could be there, vesicle or blister formation is the peculiar sign of the FMD virus. And mostly ye jo vesicles aapko dekhne ko milenge, these are all on tongue, dental pad, gums, soft palate, nostrils, interdigital spaces mein. Pregnant cases, cows, they may abort. जितने भी प्रेग्नेंट एनिमल्स हैं, अबॉर्शन के चांसेस आर देयर इफ़ दे आर इन्फेक्टेड विद दिस एफएमडी वायरस. लैक्टेटिंग एनिमल कैन नॉट रिकवर क्योंकि सिक्रेटरी टिश्यू गेट्स डैमेज्ड. इसी तरह शीप एंड गोट्स में द साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स आर ऑलमोस्ट सेम बट दे आर वेरी माइल्ड. बट माइल्ड लेमनेस इज could be the important sign and symptom in sheep and goat. Then pigs mein also the lesions are dry type. Itne zyada common lesions nahi hai but they are smaller in size. Agar honge vesicles so they are smaller in size and they tend to be dry type lesions. So these are the vesicles or blisters or lesions present in tongue, feet and cardiac and skeletal muscle. Tiger heart appearance is another important peculiar feature or lesion seen mostly in the young animals which are dying of this FMD virus. They have this tiger heart appearance in myocardium. They die mostly because of myocarditis, severe myocarditis. So this is another important point of FMD virus. Then sheep and goat and pigs may be tiger heart appearance is also there. Lesions jitne peculiar cattle mein hai utne peculiar sheep and goat ya pigs mein nahi hai. Then diagnosis mein humne field diagnosis dekha. Field mein mostly you can diagnose it using the signs, going for visualizing the signs and symptoms of the disease. Then in lab diagnosis, you need to get the sample of choice for the FMD virus. Sample could be vesicular fluid, epithelium, blood, dead animals say you can take the epithelial lesions, lymph nodes, thyroids, and jitne bhi viral specimens hote hain, they should be placed in ice and should be delivered to a lab within 24 hours. लैब टेस्ट की बात करें, यू कैन कल्टिवेट फर्स्ट ऑन लैब एनिमल्स एंड ऑल्सो ऑन योर सेल लाइन्स लाइक लैम किडनी सेल्स, BHK-21 बेबी हैमस्टर किडनी में यू कैन गो फॉर आइसोलेशन ऑफ द वायरसेस. देन आफ्टर दैट यू कैन कन्फर्म द वायरस प्रेजेंस बाय ELISA और PCR. ELISA इज़ द गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड टेस्ट फॉर द FMD वायरस विच इज़ अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट फॉर यू पीपल. नाउ वील स्टार्ट विद द control of FMD, how to control the FMD. Jitni bhi countries which are free from FMD, it is notifiable and affected that in contact animals, jitne bhi affected hai aur in contact animals and they need to be slaughtered. To wahan pe seedha test and slaughter policy follow hoti hai. Agar countries which are free from FMD, they go for testing the affecting animals and jo bhi in contact animals honge with the affected ones, they are slaughtered. Then following an outbreak, आउटब्रेक के बाद मूवमेंट रिस्ट्रिक्शंस दे आर अप्लाइड. इन्फेक्टेड प्रीमिसेस दे मस्ट बी थॉरली क्लीन एंड डिसइन्फेक्टेड एंड फॉर दैट पर्पज यू कैन गो फॉर यूजिंग माइल्ड एसिड सच एज साइट्रिक एसिड एंड एसिटिक एसिड. ऑल्सो यू कैन गो फॉर यूजिंग एल्कलीज सच एज सोडियम कार्बोनेट. दे आर इफेक्टिव डिसइन्फेक्टेंट्स फॉर डिसइन्फेक्शन फॉर द प्रीमिसेस, इन्फेक्टेड प्रीमिसेस. देन रिजर्व्स ऑफ इनएक्टिवेटेड वायरस दे आर मेंटेन्ड इन सेवरल कंट्रीज टू प्रोवाइड एन एडिक्वेट सप्लाई ऑफ वैक्सीन at a short notice in the event of a major outbreak of the disease. Then although ring vaccination around an infected premises may help to limit the spread of disease, it may also allow the development of carrier state in animals which are subsequently exposed to the virus. So here we are talking about is first test and slaughter policies. Then following an outbreak you need to go for movement restriction. They are imposed. Then premises should be disinfected using mild acids and alkalis. Then jitne bhi inactivated virus, that means the vaccines should be used. There should be an adequate supply of vaccines if there is an outbreak of the disease. Then in countries where the FMD is endemic, efforts they are generally directed at protecting the high yielding dairy cattle by a combination of vaccination and control of animal movement. So jahan pe bhi disease is endemic, you can go for vaccination. then vaccines for FMD incorporating adjuvants are there. Adjuvants हम incorporate करते हैं mostly FMD vaccines में. They are derived from tissue culture propagated viruses that have been chemically inactivated. So mostly जो virus हम use करते हैं उसको chemically inactivate करते हैं before preparing it for vaccines. They are usually multivalent vaccines containing three or more viral strains. Multiple strains use करके vaccine prepare होती है FMD की. And the protection against antigenically similar strains of virus is satisfactory and इसकी जो immunity है it lasts for up to 6 months. 6 months के बाद you need to again get vaccinated for the FMD virus. So this was all about FMD and aphthous virus. Now we'll discuss another important member of your picorna viridi family, and that is enteroviruses. Enteroviruses mostly जितने भी हैं ये table में you can see all the enteroviruses and what are they causing. सबसे पहली जो important disease है that is your swine vesicular disease which is caused by your enteroviruses. It produces mild vesicular disease but this disease is indistinguishable from FMD. तो usually ये question भी कई बार पूछते हैं swine vesicular disease और FMD को distinguish कैसे कर सकते हैं because signs and symptoms are almost same. And this is caused by your enterovirus. Then we have got another virus that is porcine enterovirus 1, जिसे porcine tissue virus भी बोलते हैं. इसमें virulent strains mostly they occur in Eastern Europe and the Malagasy Republic that causes Tetchin disease. Widely distributed mild strain they cause Teflon disease. So Tetchin and Teflon diseases they are caused by, ये usually competitive exams में कई बार question पूछा जाता है that Tetchin and Teflon like diseases they are caused by enteroviruses. अगर ऑप्शंस में एंटीरोवायरस नहीं है तो यू कैन ऑल्सो गो फॉर पिकोरना वायरसेस बिकॉज एंटीरोवायरसेस आर ए पार्ट ऑफ पिकोरना विरिडी फैमिली. बेसिकली पिकोरना वायरसेस ही हैं. सो वी हैव गॉट अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट एंटीरोवायरसेस पोर्साइन एंटीरोवायरसेस रेंजिंग फ्रॉम 2 to 11. इसकी भी इन्फेक्शन इज यूजली एसिम्टोमैटिक. ओकेजनली कॉजेज माइल्ड पोस्टीरियर पैरेसिस ऑफ द हाइंड लिम्स, रिप्रोडक्टिव प्रॉब्लम्स, डायरिया और निमोनिया. Then we have got avian enteroviruses as well, जिसके virulent strain they cause avian encephalomyelitis, an important disease of poultry, nephritis भी कर सकते हैं chickens में, hepatitis in ducks and turkeys. Then we have another member of enteroviruses as bovine enterovirus 1 and 2. They are isolated from both normal cattle and as well as animals with enteric, respiratory and reproductive diseases. So all these are your enteroviruses, but we'll take up only the swine vesicular disease which is important for you people. Picorna viridi में वैसे तो सबसे important is your FMD, but ज़्यादा detail में नहीं जाएंगे हम swine vesicular disease के, just the important points will jot, I have noted here only the important points related to swine vesicular disease. So this is a mild vesicular disease of pigs that occurs sporadically in parts of Europe and Asia. Because it is indistinguishable clinically from foot and mouth disease, accurate lab diagnosis of swine vesicular disease is essential. तभी हम इसे ज़्यादा पढ़ते हैं क्योंकि इसमें भी जो signs and symptoms हैं they are almost indistinguishable to that of FMD clinically. So we need to go for accurate lab diagnosis of swine vesicular disease. अब नाम ही swine vesicular disease है तो this is obviously a disease of pigs. And it occurs sporadically in parts of Europe and Asia. Then swine vesicular disease virus, SVDV, it is an enterovirus and it is closely related to a human Coxsackie virus B5. It is closely related to human Coxsackie virus. The pig is the natural host of the virus. Laboratory workers which are handling contaminated material, they can also become infected. So picorna viruses are also zoonotic. अभी आपने एप्थोस वायरस जो देखा था विच इज़ कॉजिंग FMD, इट इज़ ऑल्सो जूनोटिक, इट कैन ऑल्सो अफेक्ट ह्यूमन्स. इसी तरह एंटीरो वायरसेज आर ऑल्सो जूनोटिक. पिग्स से भी लैब वाले वर्कर्स दे कैन गेट कंटामिनेटेड. नाउ विल टेक अप द एपिडेमोलॉजी ऑफ द डिजीज. इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक मैटर दिस योर स्वाइन वेसिकुलर डिजीज वायरस इज स्टेबल फॉर लॉन्गर पीरियड्स इन द एनवायरमेंट एंड ट्रांसमिशन इट कैन अकर बोथ डायरेक्टली एज वेल एज इनडायरेक्ट ट्रांसमिशन इज ऑल्सो देयर फॉर दिस SVDV. नाउ द स्प्रेड ऑफ डिजीज फ्रॉम फार्म टू फार्म इट इज़ डिपेंडेंट ऑन द मूवमेंट ऑफ इन्फेक्टेड पिग्स और कॉन्टेमिनेटेड व्हीकल्स और फोमाइट्स जिनके थ्रू ट्रांसमिशन कुड बी देयर और स्प्रेड ऑफ दिस वायरस इज देयर. Tissues of the infected pigs which contain large quantities of virus, it remains infective despite the low pH values associated with the rigor mortis. Then the virus, it exhibits prolonged survival in refrigerated pork. So you can see here the epidemiology that this virus, agar organic matter present hai, toh virus can remain stable for longer periods in the environment. Both direct and indirect transmission is there. Farm to farm transmission could be there through movement of infected pigs or contaminated vehicles. Then tissues also contain large quantities of virus. Jitne bhi infected pig ke tissues hai, they remain infective despite the low pH values also. They remain infected and the virus exhibits prolonged survival in refrigerated pork. Now, the pathogenesis of the disease. Following the entry through the damage, the virus might enter through the damaged skin or by ingestion, mostly by the ingestion. Fecal route or ingestion is the most important route for most of the viruses. Following the entry, the virus, it replicates locally and subsequently it spreads via lymphatics to the bloodstream. During a viremia of short duration, many organs and tissues, they become infected. Virus shedding, which is greatest during the first week following infection, it begins before the clinical signs, they become evident. Feces and tissue material from the infected pigs may contain viable virus for months. Live virus, viruses living here in the feces and tissue materials from infected pigs for months. So it's highly contagious, highly infected, infective virus. So this was about the pathogenesis. Now we'll talk about the clinical signs, which are almost similar to that of FMD virus. Now incubation period of this swine vesicular disease virus is up to 7 days. Infection is usually characterized by mild febrile illness, fever, mild fever is there. Subclinical disease is common. Isme subclinical cases are mostly common. Transient fever is followed by the development of vesicular lesions on the feet, particularly on the coronary bands. Less commonly, the vesicles appear on the lips, tongue and snout. Lameness, dullness and inappetence that may be present. Lameness is exacerbated by pinning on concrete floors. Agar concrete floors honge, toh lameness is mostly evident or seen there. Affected animals, they remain in good condition and lesions, they heal within a few weeks. So that's not so deadly virus. Swine vesicular disease mein recovery is there. Recovery rate is good. Affected animals, they remain in good condition and lesions heal within few weeks. So these were the clinical signs and symptoms of swine vesicular disease. Mostly mild febrile or fever is there. Subclinical infection rehti hai iski. Aur vesicles itne bhi common nahi hai, but honge to they will appear on the lips, tongue and snout. Now let's discuss the diagnosis of SVD. SVD ki diagnosis is very important because laboratory tests, they are very essential for differentiating swine vesicular disease from other important vesicular disease of pigs. Like one of those is your FMD. Isme ELISA is available for rapid detection of viral antigen in vesicular fluid or in epithelial tissues. You can go for ELISA. Samples should be inoculated into monolayers of susceptible cells. The virus produces cytopathic effect. So जब भी आप वायरस को कल्टिवेट करेंगे टिश्यू कल्चर और सेल लाइंस में साइटोपैथिक इफेक्ट्स आर देयर ऑलवेज देयर. सेवरल सीरोलॉजिकल प्रोसीजर्स दे आर सूटेबल फॉर हर्ड स्क्रीनिंग फॉर एंटीबॉडीज टू SVDV. वायरस न्यूट्रलाइजेशन एंड ELISA दे आर द टेस्ट विच आर मोस्ट फ्रीक्वेंटली यूज. वायरस न्यूट्रलाइजेशन ऑल्दो द स्टैंडर्ड टेस्ट इज देयर, इट रिक्वायर्स टिश्यू कल्चर प्रोसीजर्स एंड टेक्स लॉन्गर टाइम टू कम्प्लीट देन ELISA. तभी ELISA को ज़्यादा वो किया जाता है क्योंकि ELISA गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड इसलिए बोलते हैं क्योंकि एक तो इट्स हाईली स्पेसिफिक एंड सेंसिटिव, प्लस इट रिक्वायर्स लेस टाइम एज कम्पेयर टू अदर टेस्ट लाइक वायरस न्यूट्रलाइजेशन टेस्ट. बट अ लिमिटेशन ऑफ ELISA इज दैट इट मे ओकेजनली यील्ड फॉल्स पॉजिटिव रिजल्ट, दे माइट अकर इन ELISA. दिस इज जस्ट अ लिमिटेशन ऑफ ELISA. रेस्ट ELISA इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टेस्ट फ्रॉम लैब पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. Then if we talk about the control of this, effective vaccines against your swine vesicular disease have been prepared. Commercial vaccines, they are not available because vaccination is not considered suitable as a control measure in countries which are free of the important vesicular diseases. Jin countries mein nahi hoti hai vesicular diseases, wahan pe vaccines are not available, commercial vaccines are not available. In most of the countries, SVD is a notifiable disease and eradication policies, they are enforced with restrictions on the importation of pigs and pork. Okay, control measures, they are applied following an outbreak, which includes thorough cleaning and disinfection. Following an outbreak, you need to go for thorough cleaning and disinfection using mild alkalis and acids. Control of pig movement should be there. There should be movement restriction on the animal. And boiling of waste food, which is fed to the pigs, there should be, we should go for boiling of that waste food material. So these are all the control measures of swine vesicular disease. So we have discussed in picorna viridae or picorna viruses two main members of picorna viridae, that is your enteroviruses and aphthousevirus. Aphthousevirus, they cause FMD, which is a highly significant and very important disease from veterinary point of view. And another indistinguishable disease or similar to the FMD is your swine vesicular disease, which is caused by enterovirus, again a member of picorna viridae family. This is a disease mostly occurring in pigs, and clinically it is almost similar to your FMD, but you can go for diagnosing or differentiating using appropriate lab test, and control measures are almost similar for both these diseases. So with this, your picorna viridae family is over. Jo important diseases thi we have discussed here. So next week we'll take up another important family of viruses. So we'll meet now next week. Till then, take care and have a nice day.